New Zealand's new Governor-General, Dame Cindy Kiro, is the first wāhine Māori to hold the position. Armed with a fierce intellect and a burning sense of social justice, Dame Cindy is driven by a desire to unite Aotearoa. Becoming the Queen's representative is a huge achievement, especially considering what it's taken for Dame Cindy to get there. Tāmati Rimene Sproat sat down with her the day after her investiture.
I am grateful for the opportunity to serve my country in this unique and privileged way. I am honoured to be appointed the 22nd Governor-General of Aotearoa New Zealand.
I'm assuming it's been a whirlwind 24 hours. It's your first day on the job.
It has indeed. I just wanted to get out of all the bling, the regalia, and the outfit.
We're sitting in your new whare. Have you been able to settle in?
Well, we have an apartment and the dimensions are pretty decent. The dogs are still trying to work out who they need to follow around and where they're going.
Wellington's government house is now home to Her Excellency Dame Cindy Kiro and her husband, Dr. Richard Davis. But she's never forgotten her upbringing in 1960s New Zealand.
My dad, from the north of England, Norman, is a very honest, straightforward and clever man. He was a truck driver and a manual worker, but very thoughtful, very clever. And my mother was a bit of a social butterfly, very sociable, a lot of fun. And I think this is a lovely combination. And I like to think that I got something off both of them, you know.
Where do you think you got your drive, your ambition from?
I knew from an early age what I didn't want in my life. I didn't want a job working in the factory, and I'm not trying to diss factory workers, but all of my family had been manual labourers or dairy workers.
Were you the first in your family to attend university?
I was the first in my family to attend university. I applied to Massey University. I was living in West Auckland in Te Atatū. And I thought Massey University was a Massey in Auckland. And I applied and was accepted. And when I got the envelope back, it said Palmerston North. And I thought, where's Palmerston North? I'm sorry, Palmerston, but that's what I thought at the time.
Life outside West Auckland for a young Cindy was different, sometimes confronting.
I always remember my dad telling me a story. They were trying to get an apartment in Parnell, around Parnell, because he was working on a building job there. And if my dad went along, they would say, no problem, yes, of course, you can have it. And if my mum came, they would say, no, you can't have it. I always remember him telling me how shocked he was that, you know, they would be refused when my mother came, because she would obviously look Māori. And yet they would be accepted if it was just him. He knew that was wrong behaviour and he didn't like it in his eyes. Why should anybody be treated differently to another? And again, I think that's a reflection of his values and his humanity, which, you know, I still really prize and value.
And as Dame Cindy made her way up in the world, she carried that sense of social justice with her.
I refused from an early age to be defined or confined by the limits of my own family's experiences. But I don't want to focus on unfairness. I think if we get into a victim mentality, it's not healthy. You know, we're better than that. If we think of ourselves as resilient and as able, you know, strong enough to overcome those things and to deal with the reality of the situation, to own up to what's happening and to move beyond that.
In 2003, as the new Children's Commissioner, she waded into the national smacking debate.
This, I think, sends very confusing messages to children about the link between being physically hit and an acceptance of that and love. There is no love when you're being hit.
If we want to have a society that is humane, high quality, respectful, with a high standard of living, where people are well educated, In fact, we've got to start by making sure that children are well cared for.
A public health academic and pro-vice-chancellor Māori at Auckland University, a mother who's fought for our most vulnerable communities.
I see myself as somebody who's capable of being pretty much whatever I need to be, but not being foolish about the obstacles that might confront me. I had to find my way through. But, you know, my mokos didn't have that. They've got the benefits of those things now. One person can make that much difference in the lives of all of those family connections. And that's inspiring because, you know, we convince the mother, the father, the grandmother, the grandfather to be aspirational and to achieve. And that can impact the rest of the family in positive ways.
Ah, there you are.
Here I am. Your Majesty.
Good evening.
Good morning here.
It's good morning, isn't it, to you?
Yes,
indeed. Yes. You're taking over quite soon, aren't you?
And now Dame Cindy Kiro is taking Zoom calls from the Queen as our new Governor General.
What's your relationship like with the Queen?
Well, I've met her, I admire her, and obviously I have sworn an oath of allegiance to her as the Queen of New Zealand, and I will do everything in my power to respect and uphold what she requires of me to do. So I think that says heaps.
A woman who embodies both in birth and position the Treaty of Waitangi, next year's celebrations will be the first time ever Ngā Puhi will be welcoming one of their own as the Queen's representative.
What does Te Tiriti o Waitangi mean to you?
My grandmother. She always said to me it was a sworn oath between two peoples and it was one to respect. She considered an absolute responsibility to actually uphold the mana of that agreement.
Do you think that agreement, the partnership of the treaty, has always been upheld?
I think history tells us that that's not been the case. And we have to be honest about what's happened in the past and face up to it, because otherwise, how do we move forward? So my view is we've got a good basis. We have to keep moving forward and we don't deny the past. We own up to the past, respect it, put it in its proper place and move forward.